Well, Richard, we have the world at our fingertips with the internet. You know, you can learn about
First of all, I'm finally up on the deck. How exciting is this?
Who
I'm
let that
with
happen?
You.
Who let that happen?
And Francis is looking good in his brand new CityNews jacket.
Do you like it?
I came in the newsroom the other day and I said, when do I get mine? And he goes, thing about that is, I'm going to have to get back to you on that one.
We'll get back to you.
So anyways, I'm freezing now.
Are you?
Freezing up here.
The trick to being on the deck is looking warm.
I'll try my best.
You'll try. So, okay, back to news here. Yes. You know, you can learn about ancient cultures. You can delve into treasure troves, art, literature, right? You can stay abreast of news from around the world. Go to citynews.ca. But look at the number one search on Yahoo there.
This is for 2018, the top searches in Canada, and 50% of them, they're pornography. Number one is Pornhub. Number two is simply porn.
Yeah.
Third is another pornography site I've never heard of. I've never heard of it. Then you get to CNN.
At least CNN's on there.
Amazon's on there. Yes. You got to do some shopping. But rounding out the list, X Hamster, Pornhub, just filthy sites
it's still
is what
going
we're looking
on.
At. So apparently we're doing a lot of internet browsing by our lonesome these days. Apparently is the takeaway from that one.
Well, we have very clean videos on our website, citynews.ca.
Yes.
So you can look at that.
Please go.
Okay, so then we have sleepwalking, right?
Yes.
And it's...
Sleepwalking is a thing of the past now. There's a new nocturnal phenomenon. It is sleep texting, Francis.
That's a major problem.
Not a
thing. I don't believe it.
New study in the Journal of American Health, 25% of students sleep text. So they wake up and they find that they've sent a text. They don't remember what it is. Half the time, it's gibberish.
Okay, called drunk texting, Richard. That's not sleep
texting. That's my department. It's such a problem that some people wear mittens when they go to bed so they don't text. I don't know if you remember this. 4 o'clock last night, I got a text from you. Can we bring it up? 4 o'clock text from Francis. What does that say, Francis?
Richard, I'm going to make you freeze on the balcony tomorrow.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to give you a free CityNews jacket.
I knew it.
But you're totally my BFF.
Talk to you later.
Is that what that means?
Talk to you later.
Yeah.
You text like a 14-year-old girl.
Right.
It's quite exciting.
Well, I don't even know what BFF is, and you're not.
Ouch.
No, you're nice.
Aww.
Don't worry. Okay, let's talk about this. So it's not a bird, it's not a plane, it's kind of a priest, a pastor making this grand entrance.
Now look at this, only in a United States Baptist church. It's a Pastor Orr, and he is flying in for his sermon. Apparently they had the rig all set up for a Christmas concert, and he said, I'm going to try it out. Did his whole sermon up there. The whole sermon. You know, that's the type of church I could see myself going to. I need a little theatrics.
Uh-huh. Closer to God, I guess, just a little higher than everybody else.
Just a little bit higher than everyone else, and he made quite the landing. Yeah. I'm not going to make a landing like that.
Let's bring our harness down here. Richard, we have one for you, and you're going to be out in the square doing business. How about that?
Sounds good.
Yes?
Yes, I'll go right
step
over.
Step away from the edge, Richard. We'll see you later.
Last time I come up here now.
No, come up again. It's nice.
Thanks, Francis.
Okay, bye-bye.